This is Montgomery Practical Wing Chun America, Miami branch. This is Sifu Javier.
Hi, okay. How are you?
Today we'll be going through the five center lines, okay? So the first center line divides your body in half. So if you put his tonsil out, or his elbow out, he's looking up the center line. So anything, so there's this imaginary line that cuts him in half. So anything on the right side or the left side divides everything in half. The second center line goes by the elbow, okay? So it cuts him in half in this way. So he's looking after himself, upper and lower. Right, so imagine there's a box, there's two lines here, one goes horizontal or vertical. So it divides yourself into four different boxes. So when you block, you can go up, you can go this way, or down this way. But always looking after the center line. So when you want to punch, you're always looking after the center line. Always looking after the center line. Always looking after the center line. Those are the four boxes and that divides our first and second center line. Okay, so now we're going to continue with the third center line. This is how you measure the third center line head. So we're going to use a hand here, and if we go from the top, very top of the middle finger, we go down this way, in between, here. So this is roughly where our center line is. Okay, so in between here. So when we use a technique, so on my center line, it's always here, in between the elbow joint and also the middle, from the middle finger down here. That's where the center line is. So when you punch me, elbow in punch, traditional Wing Chun punch, or any other punches, or even straight karate punch, we're looking after our center line. So we punch, I'm looking after my center line. Where we meet, this is where the third center line is. Or any punch, I'm looking after my center line, punch, I'm looking after the center line. So when my third center line meets the first center line, that creates the best effect. Okay, so we can go side. If we go this way, we can go this way. I'm always looking after my center line. I'm always looking after my third center line. When my third center line faces my first center line, I'm always on guard. So look, imagine this again. This is my first center line. This is my third center line. If you punch me this way, I'm showing you this on the side. If you're punching me through here, my center line's here, my tonsil's here, I'm off. If I move my hand over here, this is my third center line, 135. My third center line meets my first center line. Okay, it's a little bit hard to explain through a video, but think of it as this way. If somebody punches you a straight punch, he's punching my first center line. Okay? My third center line meets here. If my center line's off, I get punched. So you punch again, boom, I'm off. Boom, I'm off. Boom, now my third center line is meeting my first center line. So you punch again, I'm here. Punch again, I'm here. Punch again, I'm here. Punch again, I'm here. Okay, that's a third center line. My third center line meets my first center line. So when you punch again, I'm here. I'm here. I'm here. I'm here. We're crossing it. Here. Even over the bonsai, I'm here. I'm always looking out for my center line. Nobody punches Wing Chun punch on the street. But it's the same concept. If you're going to punch a straight punch, I'm always looking after my center line. I always look after my third and my first center line at the same time. Now we can move them off balance. Boom. Easy. Boom. Okay? I hope that explains our third center line. Okay, we're trying to explain our fourth center line. Fourth center line, it's basically in between, when we chisel, it's in the line between this line. Just like a logo. It's in between the center. Okay, so if I'm chisel with them, this four center lines in here. Okay? It's in English, it's just the danger zone. Okay? If he has a longer arm, if we're not chisel, if he's got longer arms here, it's not necessary in between this line. Depending how long his arm is. Maybe down here. So if he's got a longer arm, I've got to go one step back. And if he has a weapon, just imagine he's got a weapon here. Now the center line brings it out here. If this is a weapon, I've got to make sure this is safe. Because if he extended that weapon, if I think, oh, it's down here, if he extended this, boom, I'm screwed, okay? Right, so we're back here working on the fifth center line, okay? The fifth center line is an invisible line that goes through your core, okay? So what does it teach us? We make sure we don't lean forward, and we don't want to lean backwards. We don't go to pivot to the side, we don't want to fight when we're not even be able to balance ourselves. So it's basically an imaginary line from the head all the way down. Okay, so make sure we're standing sturdy in our guards. And that's the fifth center line of practical Wing Chun. Okay, I hope you all enjoy.